Hey, hey, hey! Hello, Artscitech followers! Have you ever thought about the possibility of life on a simple asteroid? I can see your surprise, but it could be possible. Today we are going to explore extraterrestrial life and how life originates. We are about to dive into the cosmos. As humanity searches for answers to whether we are alone in the universe, many theories about the origin of life have emerged. One of the most fascinating questions in science are, how did life begin? And what is astrobiology? While seeking answers, various geological and chemical clues observed in the universe provide us with hints. Asteroids, with their interplanetary journeys and potential to carry organic compounds to Earth, shed light on this question. In this article, we'll examine the contributions of asteroids, particularly Bennu, to the formation of life, as well as the fundamental principles of the Panspermia and the Abiogenesis theories. If you're not subscribed yet, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications to stay updated with science. A time capsule from the early days of our solar system. Bennu. Bennu was first discovered on September 11, 1999. This asteroid, approximately 50 meters in diameter, is categorized as potentially hazardous due to its close approaches to Earth. But what makes Bennu so special? NASA's OSIRIS-REx mission set out in 2016 to study Bennu more closely. In 2018, the spacecraft reached Bennu and began unveiling its secrets. First discovery: hydrated minerals. Trace of water are found in Bennu's surface. This indicates that Bennu once interacted with water. The theory was asteroids may have brought water to Earth gained more support with this discovery. Second discovery: organic molecules. Carbon-based organic molecules, the building blocks of life, were detected on Bennu's surface. This supports the idea that asteroids may have contributed to the emergence of life on Earth. On October 20, 2020, OSIRIS-REx successfully touched down on Bennu's surface to collect samples. During this process, it was discovered that the asteroid's surface was looser and sandier than expected. On September 24, 2023, the sample collected by OSIRIS-REx successfully reached Earth. These samples contain amino acids and nucleobases, the fundamental building blocks of DNA. Now scientists are questioning whether the origin of life might be linked to panspermia rather than abiogenesis. So what is panspermia? It's the theory that the seeds of life travel through the universe and are carried between planets by meteoroids, comets, and asteroids. According to this theory, life on Earth might have begun thanks to microorganisms from space. However, it's important to remember that this theory doesn't fully explain the origin of life. If life came from space, how did it begin out there? This question remains a great mystery. While some scientists believe panspermia could be real, the majority find abiogenesis theory, which focuses on volcanic vents, more plausible. So, what is abiogenesis? It's a scientific theory that explains how life emerged from non-living matters. This theory suggests that in the Earth's early days, inorganic compounds like water, methane, and ammonia reacted with energy sources to form organic molecules such as amino acids, sugars, and nucleotides. Over time, these molecules evolved into more complex structures, leading to the first cells. The Miller-Urey experiment demonstrated that organic compounds could be synthesized from non-living matter, supporting the abiogenesis theory. Current research explores processes like RNA world hypothesis and hydrothermal vents to explain the origin of life. While abiogenesis seeks to answer how life began on Earth, theories like panspermia suggest that life may have originated elsewhere in the universe. However, abiogenesis remains an active area of research since it hasn't fully solved the mystery of our life's origin. Both panspermia and abiogenesis offer different perspectives on the origin of life. Panspermia suggests that life may be universally spread, while abiogenesis argues that life could have emerged under Earth's own conditions. These two approaches don't necessarily contradict each other. Instead, they suggest that multiple factors may have contributed to the formation of life. Current experiments and space missions, such as those analyzing asteroid samples in laboratories, are investigating the validity of these theories. Data from space research indicates that both universal and local processes may have played a role in the emergence of life. These suggest that life in the universe may not have originated from a single source, but could have been influenced by many different factors. Some of the best examples of this are Jupiter's moons, Titan and Europa. Remember how I compared the 500-meter-wide Bennu asteroid to the Jupiter's moons at the beginning of the video? Well, here is what I'm talking about. Beneath Europa's icy surface lies a likely massive liquid water ocean, making it one of the most promising environments for life. This ocean, potentially filled by energy from hydrothermal vents, could support an ecosystem. The abundance of water, one of the fundamental building blocks of life on Earth, makes Europa incredibly significant for life research. Titan, on the other hand, attracts scientists' attention with its thick atmosphere, organic molecules, and lakes of liquid methane and ethane. The organic compounds in Titan's atmosphere hint at complex chemical reactions that could lead to life. Additionally, Titan offers a unique window into how life might develop in a chemical environment completely different from Earth's. Both moons are primary targets for future missions planned by space agencies and scientists. NASA's Europa Clipper mission aims to study Europa's ocean, surface cracks, and potential habitable regions in detail. Meanwhile, missions to Titan will focus on its planet-like atmospheric structures and complex organic chemistry. Imagine, could a building block found on one asteroid also exist on another? Just in the Kuiper Belt alone, there are billions of asteroids. Forget the solar system, think about the galaxy. Life might be closer to us than we ever imagined. Asteroids could be cosmic carriers carrying the building blocks of life. The organic molecules found on Bennu support this idea. What if these molecules also help life begin on other planets? This could mean we are not alone in the universe. The scientific field that researches this is called astrobiology. Astrobiology is the scientific discipline that investigates how life began, evolved, and where it might exist in the universe. This field brings together biology, chemistry, astronomy, and geology to understand extraterrestrial life. Astrobiologists focus on the presence of water, organic molecules, and energy sources when searching for signs of life. For example, ancient riverbeds on Mars, Europa's subsurface ocean, and Titan's methane lakes are some of the most promising environments for life. Additionally, celestial bodies like asteroids and comets may carry the building blocks of life. The organic molecules found on Bennu support this idea. What if these molecules also help life begin on other planets? Astrobiology doesn't just search for extraterrestrial life. It also questions how widespread life might be in the universe. For humanity, this isn't just a scientific curiosity. It's an existential question. Are we alone? Or are there other life forms out there? These are the kinds of questions astrobiologists strive to answer. The secrets hidden in the depths of the space are both a source of curiosity and inspiration for humanity. From Bennu to Europa, Titan and other asteroids, as we search for signs of life in the universe, we are also uncovering our own origins. The Panspermia and Abiogenesis theories offer different perspectives on how life began. But both theories show us one thing: the universe holds infinite potential for life. Perhaps life began on Earth and spread across the universe, or maybe it started somewhere else and reached us. In either case, knowing we are not alone in the universe is a great source of hope for humanity. Science continues to find new answers to these questions every day. Here at Artscitech, we are thrilled to be on this journey of discovery with you. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications, because the secrets of the universe are still waiting to be uncovered. Until the next video, stay curious and stay scientific.